This is Away from Mercy, a Nina Vale mystery, book 6, written by Kate Bold, read by Vivian. Prologue. And now, lie flat. Melt down into your yoga mats. We're aiming for a state of utter relaxation, a meditative phase, where body and mind will be at perfect peace. Making sure to have a smile in her voice, keeping her tone as calm as she wanted her students to feel, Marissa Trent sat cross-legged on her own mat, watching the 8 prone figures on the grass in front of her. It was a beautiful spring morning in Seattle, and she was wrapping up her 3rd successful outdoor yoga session for the season. These popular classes were held in the local botanical gardens on Mondays. As she always did, she was encouraging her students to enter a state of shavasana, the resting and restorative yoga pose that all students loved. It was also known as the corpse pose. That fact flickered through her mind, bringing a sudden chill as she stared at the 8 motionless bodies lying in the dappled shade under a big leaf maple tree. She'd always disliked the name. Yoga was an affirming, life-giving, spirit-boosting form of exercise. And the class ended with a pose named after a dead body? Start with your heed, she said, determined not to let these negative thoughts intrude into the vibe she was sending out to her students. Let your heed be totally still, resting on the grass, and release your neck muscles. Relax, relax those neck muscles, and make sure there's no tension in your shoulders. Breathe gently, and with every exhalation, feel yourself become as still as the rocks, as still as the trees. Now, your core muscles, your stomach, your hips, allow them to sink into the ground. Your legs are heavy, heavy, and you must release the tension in your feet, letting it drain out so that you are at peace, mentally quiet, and at one with nature. She made a real effort to keep her voice as level and calm as she could. After all, she was a calm, easygoing person. It was seldom that she lost her temper. On those rare occasions, she'd be upset about it for weeks afterward. Speaking in her low, soothing voice, Marissa could see that the words were having the desired effect on her students. They all looked as relaxed as could be, as if she could turn her back on them and walk away and leave the 8 women slumbering peacefully for an hour. But her job was to lead the class and also to make sure that it wasn't interrupted. Holding a yoga class in a public garden had pros and cons. It was accessible and free, and the students loved it. But she worried about troublemakers, always fearing that some man would insist on trampling his way right through her class, laughing or making scornful comments that would destroy the peace of the session. So far, it hadn't happened. There was nobody around, usually, so early on a Monday. Not a soul. Usually, the gardens were so quiet that Marissa felt she could lie down herself and join her students in the corpse pose, without worrying that there would be any trouble ahead. Today, there was somebody who she could vaguely see, beyond the row of shrubs that were planted on the left-hand side of the large tree. It was making her uneasy to see the shape of a person who didn't seem to be going anywhere. It almost seemed as if this broad-shouldered figure was standing and watching. Oh, get a grip, she chastised herself. Perhaps he's just enjoying the view of the orchids. They're planted beyond those shrubs. Or maybe he's listening to a podcast on earphones. At any rate, he's not marching up to you and interfering with your class. Stop being fearful of things that haven't happened yet. She guessed that was just who she was, but it was better to think ahead and make sure the class was safe and peaceful than to have a nasty surprise ahead. And relax, and simply be. Free your mind, allow it to be as tranquil as your body. Be at peace. At peace, she said, keeping her words soft, little more than the gentle sighing of the wind in the trees. Then, adding just enough energy to her tone, she said, and now, stretch. Bring your body and mind out of the state of rest and back into the present. Feel the sun, feel the warmth. Breathe deeply, and let calm energy flow into every part of your body. And sit up. For a few moments, there was no change. Every student was still, motionless, giving her that uneasy pang again. Was it a memory?
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.